I was in shock after I heard about what our Treasury Secretary said about the dollar. I'll explain exactly what she said and how we can protect ourselves from the damage caused by what they are doing. Without further ado, let's explore. We know that the dollar has been losing value at a rate of 3% from last year at this time, which was an already increased inflation rate. It's been bouncing around well above 3% for over a year, and before that, much higher. Inflation is hurting a lot of Americans here in this country. But that's not the only thing that's being hit with the dollar, and it's losing its standing around the world. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen was once again admitted that sanctions affected the U.S. dollar. She testified last week before the House Financial Services Committee on how to protect the status of the U.S. dollar. Yellen raised concerns about the U.S. pressing sanctions on Russia in 2022 that led BRICS essentially to kick off the start of the de-dollarization agenda. She said that, quote, "The more sanctions the U.S. impose, the more countries will seek financial transaction methods that do not involve the U.S. dollar. And make no mistake, some of them will be forced, not voluntarily, but because they don't trust each other, to use gold as a backdrop, as a way to be able to give confidence in the transactions that may take place. It's going to take quite some time, but I think it's going to happen." And Janet Yellen is the has put her signature on this dollar bill right here that you see before you. And already we know that the dollar is in a greater threat now than it has been since 1971. Yeah, or 1973 when essentially we were saved by the petrodollar system, which we've just now has been abandoned by Saudi Arabia. That's another chink in the armor of the dollar's hegemony. Now, we go into it further here by the Global Times that she's admitting sanctions could impact the U.S. dollar's dominance as concerns mount over the dollar's hegemony. U.S. Secretary of Treasury Janet Yellen testified before the House Financial Services Committee. She said that one of her concerns is how best to protect the international status of the U.S. dollar as U.S. financial sanctions have pushed more countries to seek alternative financial transaction methods that do not involve the U.S. dollar. The remarks from Yellen have shed light on growing concerns regarding U.S. dollar's hegemony. Experts believe that the weaponization of the U.S. dollar will reduce its dominance as the world moves towards local currency settlements and accelerate policies to facilitate de-dollarization. China and other countries are actively promoting local currency settlements and multilateral cooperation, offering more choices and possibilities for the global financial order. In her testimony before the Committee on Financial Services and U.S. House of Representatives, Yellen said that the more sanctions the U.S. impose, the more countries will seek financial transaction methods that don't involve the U.S. dollar. For a long time, the U.S. has abused its dollar hegemony, shifting domestic crisis and harvesting global wealth by damaging the economic and financial stability of and well-being of other countries. It is also used as a tool to impose financial sanctions, isolating other countries from the dollar payment system. There has been an accelerating trend of de-dollarization over recent years, driven by the U.S. wielding its financial sanctions, leading some countries to be able to settle in dollars and prompting them to seek alternatives. And if they're unable to settle there, what are the choices they have? This will have a certain impact on the international status of the U.S. dollar in time. By the way, right now, about 58% of foreign transactions or foreign reserves are in the U.S. dollar. But still, over 80% of international transactions still occur with the dollar. It's still the strongest of all the currencies out there. And both those numbers are being chipped away, especially what we heard in Zambia, as they are prohibiting the use of the dollar now. And it will have a certain impact on the international status. that the dollar hegemony has led to other countries exploring the path of de-dollarization through diversification of currency reserves, establishing local currency settlement mechanisms, and strengthening international cooperation. Now, the other thing that's leading this is not just the weaponization. I think even more importantly is inflation itself. And even though the dollar's inflation is less than that of other countries, there are still some countries whose currencies are more stable than ours in terms of inflation. But they don't have the prestige that the dollar has. So this is going to be a long, drawn-out, struggle to move in that direction, which is why gold very well could play a role here. It's one of the reasons why central banks around the world since 2022 and even a little bit beforehand have been accumulating more gold in their vaults because they don't trust any currency, including that of the dollar. In June, Saudi Arabia joined the Central Bank Digital Currency Initiative for International Trade, which may set the stage for a wider local currency payments for oil trade between China and Saudi Arabia and reduce the reliance of the U.S. dollar. And that comes on the heels of Saudi Arabia essentially abandoning the petrodollar system. In April, the Maldivian Minister of Economic Development and Trade, Mohammed Saeed, confirmed that Maldivians would soon have the option to settle their import payments using Chinese yuan to meet the government's objective to diversify its settlement currency from the U.S. dollar. More choices are being made now than they have really since 1973, leading to this. A report from the Society of Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunications showed that in May, the Chinese yuan maintained its position as the fourth most active currency in global payments by value for a seventh consecutive month with a share of 4.47%. But the Chinese renminbi still has some issues and troubles of its own. And that's just it, folks. It's going to be a long, drawn-out road abandoning the dollar or trying to declare independence therein. And so therefore, the dollar still has quite a bit of status around the world. And that's not going away anytime soon. But, and however, the fact that our Treasury Secretary, Janet Yellen, made that statement tells you everything you need to know. The dollar is on pins and needles in some extent because people understand what's happening. They know. In fact, many states here in the U.S. have already taken action. First and foremost, by essentially preventing taxation on gold and silver, repealing all those taxes, which is the first step to the recognition of gold and silver as sound money, as ascribed in the U.S. Constitution, Article 1, Section 10, that no other payments other than gold and silver shall be for legal tender. This script here, which is made of cotton linen fiber, is something quite different. It is a note that has been losing value by design year over year, and they are comfortable with the 2% inflation rate. None of us should be comfortable with that. They are robbing us, and they're not even doing it blind. It's all out in the open. Their eyes are open. And when we think about COLA, or cost of living increases in our paychecks, if you really look at that, it's not a raise. It's just a cost of living expense or payment. But that is really just an arbitrary number, semi-arbitrary, because it averages out things. A lot of those things, the most important things that you're paying for, have a much higher inflation rate than 2% in a normal economy, much less what we're seeing right now with things to the tune of between 20 and 50 and even 100% or 120%, as is the case in the United Kingdom, as shared with me by a member of this community, Cybercurrent Twitcher, where salt was going for 120% increase. It's insane what's going on. And this is why we need a stable store of value. And this is where gold and silver come into play, because they provide you that. Even with price fluctuations, gold and silver provide a stable store of value over the long course of time. Why? Because of the paradigm shift of thinking. It's a wealth system. It is indeed a savings vehicle, an insurance policy against economic instability, against inflation. We measure our wealth in ounces, not dollars. And when you think about that in that terms, that gives you the confidence that you're doing the right thing by having some gold and silver in your portfolio. Now, obviously, with everything, it does require some balance we must think in terms of dollars. We must think in terms of our local currency, our national currencies. It's just in a way in the nature of economics these days. But gold and silver and having them set aside and apart is essentially what the ultimate true test of the historic money that has been around for thousands of years. And so measured against that, you do look at it in terms of ounces, which is why I applaud the Mexican government for not putting denominations on their gold and silver bullion coins, because those are arbitrary. And it's really the value is measured from within the metal contained in the planchets stamped upon those itself. They are, in a sense, coins codified by the legislature there. Smartly so. Whereas here in the United States, well, we put a much smaller denomination on our coins, $50 for this 1 ounce gold eagle and $1 for this silver American eagle. You know that even though you could take and spend it as $1 at the store for legal tender, we know you'd be fooled to do that. And they don't want you to do that. That's why they put the small denominations on them. But there's other reasons too, but I won't get into that. But there you have it. So a stunning admission by Janet Yellen, our Treasury Secretary, who, by the way, used to be the Fed chair of the Federal Reserve. So there you go. Let me know what your thoughts are about this story. I'd like to extend a multitude of gratitude to each and every one of you for taking the time to watch and to encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.